Welcome to a showcase of MoviePrint, an app to create screenshots of entire movies in an instant. You drag in a movie, customize its look, and save it as a MoviePrint. So what is a MoviePrint? A MoviePrint is an image made out of screenshots of a movie. It helps you present, analyze, or remember movies with the help of a single image. If you have lots of movies and try to keep an overview, or you want to get a feel of a movie, its color or pace, or you want to include some moods of movies in a presentation. In all these cases, MoviePrints are helpful. So let's have a look on how to create them. First, you drag in one or more movies. If you want, you can also use the Open Movies button here. The first movie is automatically displayed as a MoviePrint, where frames from the movie are captured in a regular interval. If you're fine with the default settings, you can save a MoviePrint right away. But let's have a look on how you can customize them. Click on More Settings to open the side menu. Here, you can define how many columns and rows the MoviePrint should have. In case you plan to actually print it on paper later on, you can show the paper preview to find the grid which works best for you. Note that with a lot of thumbs, the app can get laggy, depending on your computer setup. As soon as you click Apply, the new frames are captured and displayed. If you only want to change the column count while keeping exactly these captured frames, you can unselect Change Thumb Count. Let's close the menu so we can manipulate the individual thumbs of the MoviePrint. In case you only want to create a MoviePrint of a selected part of the movie, you can set in and out points. Just hover over the thumb you want to become the in point and click on In. The frames of the MoviePrint get recaptured to reflect the change. In the same way, you can set the out point. Be aware that setting in and out points will change all thumbs. So it is best to do that before you have manipulated the individual thumbs. Sometimes, when you have a large grid, the thumbs can get quite small. In this case, you might have to zoom in to make some of these adjustments. If you want to have more thumbs of a selected part of the movie, you can easily insert a thumb anywhere you like. Just hover over the plus icons on the left or the right to insert thumbs before or after. You can also easily hide the thumbs you do not like by clicking on Hide. In the upper right corner, you can display the hidden ones again. And with clicking on Show, you can bring them back. If you want the thumb to display a different frame, click on the scrub symbol and drag the mouse, while still keeping the mouse button down. You will see the previous and the following thumb, where you can drag between them to select a new frame. If you're happy with the selection, just let go of the mouse. You can easily cancel the action by dragging the mouse down onto the cancel button or under the change afterwards. And if you're happy with all thumbs, but not with its order, just drag the thumbs to another position. Voila, that's it. When you're happy with the selection, you can find some more customization options in the side menu. You can change the margin, show a header with different information, and decide if you want to use rounded corners or also show the hidden thumbs. And there's also the option to display the frame number or time code. You can specify the output path, output size, and format. Additionally, you can also save the individual frames whenever you save a MoviePrint. For saving a specific frame, you can just click on Save on the thumb directly. Now click on the Save MoviePrint button, and the MoviePrint gets saved in the specified location. Congratulations! You have just created your first MoviePrint. If you have dragged in multiple movies, there is also the option to save all MoviePrints at once. And here is a new feature you can experiment with. With shot detection, the app tries to detect cuts in a movie. Currently, the algorithm is simple and far from perfect, but it is still fun to play with. First, You scan the movie, which depending on the length and size can take a while. You can then use the threshold to change the sensitivity and run it again. After doing the shot detection, the thumbs are shown in a so-called timeline view, where the width of the thumb reflects the length of the detected scene. Also here, you can change the layout and save it as a movie print. That's it for today. Thanks for watching, and remember, if you have feedback or want to be kept up to date, you can drop me a line directly from within the app.